word this time, and our study this time with our financial wizard, Nick White. We thank you, Lord God, for the wisdom that he shares with us. We thank you, Lord God, for all that we've gained through this financial wisdom series. We thank you. We ask you to bless him and prosper him in his endeavors, in his business, as you have taught us principles. We pray that we all would prosper, that we'd all grow wise in our discipline and our commitment to being financially wise. So we bless you for tonight. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Nick White, right. Bless you, sir.
Thank you. Well, we're about to wrap it up for these couple sessions. Man, I really appreciate Pastor allowing me to come speak to you guys about this. And I want to ask you guys any questions, specific questions that you might have had from what we already discussed. You come on to the front. You come on. It's okay. Well, I ain't calling you out, but hey, we here. You come on to the front.
I will say this. I've been trying to look at those budgeting percentages that you gave us on our budgets.
Okay.
And it's going to take a lot of adjustment.
Right.
I think I'm out of balance on a lot of stuff.
Okay.
And so I think my first step is going to have to be how I get to even getting in balance.
Gotcha. Okay.
You know?
Now,
that's my challenge.
Now that's good. I'm glad you brought that up. The whole point of that format is to give you a generic format of how to get started.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if you have to adjust those according to your budget plan, because your situation may be different than someone else's, right?
Okay.
So in order to, like you said, imbalance that, you can actually adjust on some of those percentages to be able to get into that proportion.
Okay.
Case in point, you might have to enlarge your housing income, the housing portion of it, to be able to eliminate some other things. So you might have to increase that to 50% versus 35 or something.
Mm-hmm. game up to the final.
That's right. You know that's saying? Right. That's right. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. And it's right. Good for you knowing that. So that's a good thing. So yeah, we definitely have a conversation. Because I probably got some good options for you. Well, mainly what we have is when you're talking about annuities, we have a annuity that's good for anybody that's over the age of 45, and it's a 5-year annuity program. Now, it's for people, like I was saying, like I got off to a late start, thing like that. It has no fees, right?
And what's the name of it?
It's an annuity. It's an annuity, right? It's called capital, a structured capital. That's what it's called. But it's with access. But it has no fees, right? It's great. It's just a 5-year plan, right? And it's for to growing your money. It's for the growth of your money. So you take it after that 5 years, you take it and put it into another annuity that'll pay you out for the rest of your life. Because that's all a pension plan is. A pension plan, all it is annuity, right? Just a different name for it. Just a company name for it versus an independent name or whatnot. So you just take that. That into that annuity, whatever that growth is, you put that over there, and then you pension off of each month, right? So that's what that's for. So you can actually have that option to do that. So that's just one option. And then once you get into this annuity right here, the cornerstone annuity, the retirement cornerstone annuity, there's a whole bunch of other options that hold long term care. And I just like the commitment to it. You know, most annuities is 8 to 12 year commitment. Mm-hmm. It's only 5 years, right? You still got access to your money, you know, and then you don't have the fees that's attached to it. So I think it's a great product. I mean, it came for the growth of your money, being able to protect your money from the market and all that type of stuff. You know, for some people, when you get to the close of retirement, you don't really need to be in the market. Just be real about it, right? Because you don't have the time to recover, right? But you know, the ups and downs of the market, it's always going to be like that, no matter what. It's been doing that from testing time. Like going upstairs with a yo-yo. You know, that's all it is, right? So you don't have really time to recover by the time you get, you know, older. So you want to protect your money in something like annuity, right? So protect your gains, basically. Right? That's what we're trying to do, protect your gains. But that's part of legacy building as well, because an annuity can be able to leave it to your wife. She can still pinch off of it. Choose to, right? Leave for the kids so they can be a beneficiary, right? So that's all part of that. That's all part of that structure. So yeah, that's why I said we have a good conversation about that. Anybody else? I think the majority of what we talked about, you know, was just pretty much planning, like putting an actual strategy together. You know what I'm saying?
Strategy.
Yeah, strategy. I think that's the most important part. And each one of you guys is going to be individual. You know, everybody in different spaces in life. So just having a strategy. If you guys can just remember this. How to understand how to protect today and how to get into tomorrow. If y'all can understand how most people start off with no money and you're trying to build money, but if you got debt, you're trying to get out of the debt by the time you reach your retirement age, whatever it is. All right, that's simple, right? The strategy is in between these two windows, right? That's the strategy. So that's what talking about the budgeting, understanding how that budgeting plan works. You know what I mean? I think that's very, very important. Everybody has to understand how to be able to put your bills together. Who actually went home and did the snapshot thing that I passed out? Anybody?
I started on that. I did start working.
Okay.
So I've got a better picture than I had before.
Right. So everybody needs to know their expenses. See, nobody wants to do it because they understand they feel like they don't make enough money. Mm-hmm. That's the problem. You got to start somewhere. Okay, where you are, right? What are you doing? What you doing? And this is why. Now, you got to understand that when you're managing the money that you have, that's why God gonna bless you more, because you open to managing what you got. You understand that?
Yeah.
Just being problem. Like I told last time, this room should be packed. It's a resource. Why should you learn about the resource? If you go to work every day, if you constantly get up every single morning and go to work, you need somebody to show you what to do and be able to balance that. Simple as that. Right? So now, what question do you guys have about that point? Because it's to this point now, it has to get to the point where it gets to specifics to where you guys are. We talked about a generic version of what we got going on, but now we got to get down to specifics, right? And that's why I put my number down here. Y'all get take my number, because we can talk personally. I know y'all want to talk in front of everybody about y'all money. Y'all got so much, y'all don't want to talk to everybody. I know how it works. Right, y'all want to tell them about the million y'all got. You know what I'm saying? I know how it works. So, but no, that's real though. I want you guys to take my number. We're gonna talk individually. You know what I'm saying? And I might have a little surprise for you guys to actually call me to actually set something up, you know, personally, kind of see where you're going.
You talked about the Acorns account. What was the second one you talked about?
Simple. Yeah, simple. It's just a car.
You'll be amazed the little bit that just you
to the Starbucks or whatever, guess what? You write down for the taxes. It's a business expense. I'm having my business partner, my wife. It's a business expense, right? I'm telling you. That's it. Come on, man. Like we throwing away money because we so sold out on a job. Victoria and blah blah blah. So can nobody use Victoria and such such such, right? So if you do, what's your business? You
say Shalom Be Designer.
Oh, okay. So what is that like?
No.
Graphic design?
No. I do like lap scarves and hand
me out. Oh, okay. Okay. Well, good. Yeah, that's all that is. That just so you have an LLC? You have an LLC? You wait on. You crafting this stuff.
No,
you learning. I'm saying, but it's a business.
But so I'm saying I'm learning about the business.
Oh,
Okay. So just like you gave me that information, now I can go back and even pull more. But go ahead and give me more.
Go LLC it. And because you get the perks of a business owner.
Okay.
Right? So, like I said, you get to write off things that, and you know why they take tax out your paycheck at a job? Government don't treat you. That's it. That's the only thing they take. That's the fee they would come to work with.
Mm-hmm.
Man, I'm telling you, man, it's crazy once you think about it. But the perks go to you. You're the business owner, the perks go to you. I'm going to show you why, though. They thinking if you go open up a small business, majority of the time you're going to do what? You're going to expand, you might hire people, right? Because you're a business owner. You can't do everything. So guess what? If you hire somebody that sold for 2 days, so majority of the time in a corporation, now this is what happened in corporate America. A corporation will go hire thousands of people, right?
Mm-hmm.
So guess who they're gonna take taxes from first? Those thousand people, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm gonna give the business owner tax breaks because if he go open another business, guess who I'm gonna take more taxes from?
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So we ain't even thinking about this, as far as being business owners, we're not even thinking about this. You know what I mean? This stuff we need to be thinking about. Them kids, they need to be LLC passed down to them. We talk about legacy building. That's part of it. And guess what? Even if they call them filing bankruptcy, just say something happened, you file bankruptcy on your business instead of you personally. See, people be tripping and talking about Donald Trump, blah, blah, blah.
And
blah.
I'm going to say what was really funny. I had another pastor.
It's no different in here. So what I'm saying is, and just speak from a business standpoint, I know you want to talk about that. That's a portion of being able to understand how that actually works. You know, getting your LLC and expanding your business.
Let me say one more thing. Because when I first had that conversation, I was like, that's dishonest.
Right.
That was my first thought. That's dishonest. That was my first thought. Why are they doing that? Because that's dishonest. That's not integrity.
Right.
But the truth of the matter is, that's the way our business system is structured.
That's right. That's it.
It's not, and that's how Trump's getting
that's
over
it.
Because we'll say he didn't file taxes, he didn't do this. No, he stayed within the laws of the land.
That's right.
That's why he's changing taxation laws now. And we're not paying attention to. We're looking at all the smoke screens.
Right.
But I heard on the news this morning about the number of big businesses that are getting that are paying no tax.
Oh, yeah.
Amazon is not. Can you imagine how much money Amazon makes?
And they went up, and they went up. Notice they went from not having taxes to collecting taxes.
then it's not a lack of integrity to work within the system. Because we can fuss at Trump all we want to, but he won't go to jail.
That's right.
Because like he worked the system.
That's right. But that's the problem.
We don't like this. We think it's just
right. We don't want the system. That's right. So, and honestly, and I'm going to talk about this, and I want to get you guys' question. I hate I got to run, but I want you guys to understand the mentality here in Montgomery was different. It's different. I had to learn. This is about demographics, right? The reason a lot of these bigger plants come here is because the mentality is already here. I ain't got to change it. It's already here. Slavery came here years ago, right? We were bred and born in the slave. Our grandparents, right, taught us that same cycle, right? So it's embedded in us to do what? Go get a job. We're not even thinking about going on a bid. As soon as we think about going on a bid, I guarantee you, majority don't say, well, no, don't do that now. Don't go on a bid or nothing. You go work for somebody. I need to go get a job. Right. Go get your job. Nice desk job or something like that and work for them. Right? Get you a gold watch when you retire. Yeah. Right? And I asked my dad, I said, Dad, how did that work for you? Like, real talk, did that work? That's all I knew. Right? And I'm talking about integrity, like, I felt good about the fact that that's what he did to feed his family. That's all he knew. And I was teaching him that. But like I said, the mentality is already here. So that's why it's so hard to pack a room out when you're talking about money. That's why it's so hard to talk about business in Montgomery.
Unless you tell them they're going to get rich.
Mm-hmm. Unless you tell them that. Yeah. Unless you tell them that. And that's a whole different scenario. Mm-hmm. Totally different scenario. So I want everybody to get, because just like, I really think if we understand business, we'll respect each other in a different way. Mm-hmm. I truly think that. As a matter of fact, I know that. Mm-hmm. Right? Me and my brother talk about this all the time. It's amazing. When we start talking business, how we respect each other when it comes to business. Because I'm going to tell you why. We understand how difficult it is when it comes to business. See, people think now that you can see these bigger corporations, you can see you seeing when they make it. Right? Mm-hmm. You ain't seeing the grind.
Right.
You ain't seeing the times you done cried your eyeballs out because you know you want this thing to work. You knew you believed in it. You didn't went and bought every piece of cloth you could to make sure you sold this thing, right? And now all of a sudden they see, well, you open up 2-3 stores, you know, you been got this Mercedes Benz, you know, all this other. They ain't see that part of it. Now, oh, that's for her though. You know, they ain't seen the grind, the hustle, and the work you put into it. You see what I'm saying? So once we see, I can respect what you're doing, because I know what you're going through. Anytime somebody trying to start a business, I don't know what you're going to go through. It is what it is, right? But all that's part of building a legacy, because we got to learn how to be. It's four ways to make money in this world. Why are we so stuck on one? Why? That's what we're taught, right? So why are you not trying to learn? I ain't saying quit your job tomorrow. I ain't saying that. But I am saying learn different ways to make money, right? It's a resource. Right? It's all about building God's kingdom. That's what I talked to Pastor about. Like, this is all a part of it. If we all understand structurally how to be able to do these things, we can help each other. Mm-hmm. Expand, because that's all it is. Money is just a resource, guys. It's not the primary source. It's a resource. I don't know why we're so scared of it. I don't understand. Right? Why we shouldn't be learning more about this? You go to work every single day in order to say, I can pay my life bill. I can keep my mortgage, you know. I can maybe put some clothes on my kids and eat, you know.
What is that saying?
Right. So how? Because I think that is just what you're supposed to do anyway.
Yeah.
That's the minimum. So you're talking about prospering. Talking about prosperity. Is that prosperity? Like, is that really being prosperous? Is that what we truly want, though? Like, deep down in your heart, can you really say that's what you truly want? Can you say that right now to your kids, that's all I want to do is survive. I just want to survive. I don't want to deep down in your heart, though, do you believe it? Are
I
you?
Me.
No, I'm saying, but okay, good question, right? Good, I'm gonna tell you, good comment. I'm gonna get you to understand something. This is even biblical when it talks about this, right? When you around fools, you'll mess around and move. So if you around people who only thinking about working a job, who only thinking about being doing the basics of life, what are you gonna do? Now this didn't register to me till a couple years ago. And I started being around hardworking, grinding people that understood what it was. Like, money is a byproduct of what they became as individuals. It's just a byproduct. So this dude tell me, man, I make $30,000 a week. Like that ain't no, like that ain't no money. But he talking to me that, like, I'm thinking like, okay, you need to go on TV and you know, so we thinking that, right? So I want you guys to think about how you can do the same things if you believe that you can. And you stop hanging around people and stop thinking that it's wrong to do that. Hang around, if you got a whole bunch of chicken, you got an eagle to go over there and hang with them chicken, he gonna become a chicken too. Is that not right? He don't know he can fly, because the chickens ain't flying, they just going around. He don't even realize his potential. Right? So this is a part of, like, all this is a part of understanding the basics of life, but you got to understand how to prepare the basics, use the fundamentals, right, and be able to take it to the next level. Because pastors don't need that, because the growth of the church has to go on. It's going to be for the next generation, regardless of how we think it. It's going to be for the next generation. And I'm in alignment because I believe that, because that's what I'm living for, because I understand what's going on. I understand what's going to happen. I see it. I just, honestly, until I actually, and it's not really bad, but I started hanging around people that was thinking like me, though, because I was one of those people. But I knew when I was working, I was like, I don't know what I'm supposed to do. I don't supposed to be here, but I got to pretend like I'm supposed to be here. I don't want to step out of character. Nobody because they don't think like me. You see what I'm saying? This is what we doing on a daily basis, right? So that's why we don't want to even look at our finance, our expense rate, our expenses, and things like that. We don't want to even do it. Like I said, who all did it? I know we have some people coming, like, who all looked at it? They did the little snapshot thing that I gave you guys, the paperwork. She put that head down, so I know she didn't do it. So why not, though? Why not? Think about it. Why you didn't do it? Hard to face. Right? It's hard to face, but you gotta face it. Because the important part is you can face it and look at it. So you don't want to get rid of spending money at McDonald's or actually rearranging your whatever it is. Right? Right. You don't want to say, well, I can't go out because I ain't got $30 or whatever the case might be. I gotta go out. I gotta go to the club, girl, because such are gonna be there tonight. I got to go.
Don't pull.
That is a lie. That's a definite lie. But either way, any expense that you have that you don't want to do, you don't want to do that. You don't want to change it. But in order to get to where you want to be, you're gonna have to change it. Right? Because you started out wrong. It ain't even your fault. You wasn't taught. So why are you scared of it when you wasn't even taught the right way in the first place? So why don't you just learn it? Right? We on the same page? Right? So we gotta believe that, guys. So that's the main thing. I gotta go. I gotta wrap up. But do that. When I sit down with every last one of y'all better have it done, because I'm gonna do it. But you might as well have it done, right? Yeah, especially. So you might as well have it done, right? I was gonna give y'all some, but y'all ain't know how to do it. So I mean, I had an iPad, well, but I ain't, you know. Don't worry about it. Well, that's even worse. I'm saying, you ain't come? That's
I
right.
I got a copy now. I'm sorry.
I got
right, and look at each one of them, I want you to be able to ask me questions on how I'm going to be able to go to the next level. Not how I'm going to stay where I'm at. How I'm going to go to the next level with this. Like, how is going to truly be able to say, okay, I got this written down. This is what I'm supposed to do. How am I going to go to the next level with this? But that's what's going to happen. If you start viewing it and looking at it the right way, just like young lady was talking about the 401k, I'm telling you, I can change your life with that 401k. Just by knowledge and information, because it changed my life, so I know it can happen. The applied knowledge, I ain't talking about just knowing it. Key word, I said applied knowledge is what changed. Because I could have sat there and looked at it, oh man, that's well and good, but go work for 30 more years. I applied it. Because what other choice did I have? I don't know nothing about it. So why would I seek a professional, somebody who knows the heck they're talking about, to be able to do it? That's simple, right? So it shouldn't be hard for us to be able to do this, right? Now, next time, we're going to charge, Pastor. I think people take it more serious when you charge them money. And you charge them $25 a person.
Wasn't available enough for ministry, so God called me off my second job.
Okay.
So now I'm adjusting to go back to one job, which my regular bills is okay, but it kind of stripped me of, I won't say it stripped me, but it kind of got me on pause because now I got to feel this thing back out again. Mm-hmm. But it kind of shifted me to what my plan was, because now I don't have the income that I had to help me to get there.
Yeah.
Just say with all this investment, if there's not an excess, there are two in this. If there's not a plan that can be put into place, just to say that there's nothing extra,
right.
Which means, okay, then that means I will have to pull from where I'm already stretched.
Gotcha.
In order to put yourself in a position to grab hold of things. So is there, for me, I say, if you were to ask me tonight, okay, well, can you sign in here and do this, I would say no, simply because physically, visuals, I don't see the extra because I'm already in transition to come down. It's not that, you know, like I try to teach my children a lot of times, even like I got a daughter that correction officer, and when she got the position, I told her, do not go get this expensive apartment because you go out and you extend yourself to the pay increase, then you still not going to like what we desire versus what we need. So I done got older. I'm not into what I desire. I'm okay. I raised four kids, so I understand. Live life, do without. But my thing is, my passion is to get there, but now I'm on hold. So I'm trying to come out of holding position, but right now I'm just trying to look at things to see what can I downsize. Like, I don't really do anything, so I don't really have no hobbies. Like, going to church is my hobby. I do got cable because I have to do something to keep a sane mind. But I really don't. There's like nothing to take from to produce anything. Right,
let me help you. I'm gonna make this real simple. I'm gonna make it real simple. All of this is mental.
Well, I need you to tell my beautiful lady this is mental.
I'm gonna show you what I mean by that, right? You spoke that into your own life. You said extra.
I know that's what we look for.
Right? Mm-hmm. It shouldn't be extra. Mm-hmm. That should be a part of your plan already.
You missed my whole point.
No, I get it. No, I got what you're saying. But you said, see what you're doing, what you prepared your bills was, you prepared your bills for, I'm gonna do this, and anything extra, I gotta save.
Maybe I told you wrong. That's somewhere. But what I'm saying is, I can't take from bills to.
You just say you got a cable. That's a choice.
Oh, I'm gonna have some TV now.
Did I not say it was mental? I just said it was mental.
No, I did. I did go to a smaller package. I'm OCD. I can't do fire thing. I ain't got time to go through all these meetings.
See what you keep saying to yourself?
Well, now, I do go to work now.
But I'm trying to help you. I'm telling you.
But see, my thing is what I'm trying to do.
I'm trying to help you. I'm trying to get you to understand.
Okay, well, let's go talk about it.
Get it. Well, what else?
People,
I mean, you.
One channel at a time.
It don't have to be. It can be
anything. The channel I like, the word network and all that, is on satellite. I can't get it on.
So are you trying to get ahead or stay the same?
I'm trying to get ahead, but still watch TV.
Okay. Try to get you to come work with me
if you want. I can't say a name for Jesus.
I don't say nothing. You think I'm selling? You think I sold you anything?
Yeah.
Did I sell you something?
Yeah.
Or did I offer you something?
Same thing. But seriously though.
But I'm telling you, it's mental.
What
it's
can
mental.
You do when there is nothing you can do?
So.
But I won't say nothing.
It's always something you can do. So what I'm trying to explain to you, it's a mental. So you gotta get past that mental block of saying it's extra. Mm-hmm. Right? So you gotta be able to take that. You got to. How you do it. Right? Mm-hmm. So even it don't matter what it is, and I heard Pastor KK Milton say something the other day, like we so ashamed to go back to mama house. And he was just saying, like, we scared the downside.
Right.
Right? We scared the downsides to be able to say, because you ain't got to get away from cable forever.
I asked that question a few months ago. I said, can we move back to my mom?
Right. I'm just saying.
Don't tell the outside, y'all. I asked the question. I said, commute to church.
Right.
Mom in Birmingham. She's like, oh. I won't say publicly what they
are. Right, whatever. But you got to understand. Like, you got to understand it, but see, the way you're trying to go. You think you're going to get rid of cable forever. If you got to get rid of cable for 6 months to get ahead, then what's wrong with that? If that's what you're trying to do now. Now, it don't necessarily have to be the cable, but it's getting your mindset around the obedience of where you're trying to go. Mm-hmm. That's all it's about. It's totally mental. It's totally mental. Like, me and Sean were talking the other day. She was like, man, I want to go get this new 2019 truck and all that type of stuff, right? I was saying the same thing. Like, I like the Denali truck. Mm-hmm. But I was like, I can't do it right now. Mm-hmm. I got some things I got to do. No matter what, I got to do this. So, in order for you to, I don't think about extra. So, you got to understand how this actually works inside of it. So, you don't have to worry about the extra. See, we, all together, I'm just saying this is the mindset. We want to pay our bills and invest later. Mm-hmm. When wealthy people invest, bills.
No,
right?
though I make this bill, we're supposed to pay. Okay. Now, that's the same thing I'm talking about, even though I use the word extra. Mm-hmm. We can't take from what we've committed to pay because I committed to that, so
right.
I need to pay that.
Okay.
So that should be me. Now, this is my, this is how I look at it. If I'm going to go out and I'm going to preach and teach God's principles, then I need to live by them. So if I went out and I made this bill, then I need to pay it.
Right.
So that means this is top priority. Yes, I have desires to get better, to get to a higher level where, you know, if the sun comes up, I need it, there's no strength, all the above.
Mm-hmm.
But to me, what I'm basically trying to tell you is that when we're leaders and we're teaching these godly principles, like, we're held to that first.
Yeah.
Watch this. I got to still know how to function in that world system. So watch this. If we made the debt, we're supposed to pay it. Right? So if we made the debt over here in the world, we're supposed to get it paid. Right? That's the debt. But the world has systems that they drew from kingdom to help us deal with it. Chapter 7, ain't nothing but over here in the kingdom, the 7 year sabbatical. After 7 years, you kill it. You
Sorry.
Kill the debt. It's the same principle drawn, but the world uses it in a different way. He said in scripture, I taught this the other day on the line. If a person has a debt 6 years, the seventh year, you cancel it. So watch this. We need to get ourselves in the kingdom on the mindset of I ain't gonna buy nothing that's gonna cost me more than 7 years to pay.
Right.
So watch this. Now, since I gotta cover this area as kingdom, and the world got different rules over here, then I gotta take my mindset and say, what are the rules over here in the world that I can benefit from? Because I made the debt, but my financial situation changed. I need to be man or woman enough to call that company and say, I'm in a place where my income just was cut by 30%.
Right.
I need a lower payment. Now here's the choice. You can give me a lower payment, or I can give you your product back. Now, watch this. They don't want the product back. They don't want that house back. They don't want that house back, because that house is more than likely, it ain't in the rich folks section of town. It's in a place in town where most of us gonna be. They don't want that house back, because now they gotta carry on their books and resell it. So we gotta have enough in us to say, whatever the world is using in their system that doesn't violate God's principle, I gotta step up and ask for it. If my income is reduced, then I gotta be able to go to them and say, hey, listen, I can't pay this same note. I need a reduction in the car note. They may say, look, we know you got 4 years left on it over here,
right?
But we'll extend it to 6 years to at least get you through this temporary season. And it may mean adding some more time and loss of interest, but at least it takes you from default to where you can at least get through this year, 2 years, and then as you kick back up, you do the just thing and pay extra on it.
Everything is negotiable.
Right.
So the world, they got ways over here, just like we were talking about the tax laws.
That's right.
We don't talk about taxes. The only thing the Bible says about taxes is render unto Caesar that which is Caesar's. It don't say how to do it. It don't say how to do it. It just says give Caesar what is Caesar's. So if Caesar sets the system, in you sees your system. And if he says, I'm going to let you open a business for your family, and you start Caterers, Inc., LLC, every time you cook dinner, you do a catering job, or you cook for the church, that's a catering job, then you get your family to pray on just cooking for the church. Now, that sounds like that might be illegal, but it's not. All you got to have is paperwork. And be diligent enough to track it and meet the burden of proof of what you do.
You ain't got to do it all
yourself. You got to, I'm talking to a man now about opening a bank.
Right.
I want to own a credit union. I want our fellowship to own its own credit union. You know what it takes to own a credit union? About 30 or 40 of us have $100 apiece. If I can't find 40 people with $100, I ain't got no friends.
Right.
And if I say the kingdom agenda or LIFT, man, listen, we need 50 investors with $100 apiece. We're going to open our own credit, we're going to do our own lending, and we just need you to come get loans with us and be integrous and pay them back. Come get $300 for them and pay it back over 6 months. Because it's going to be your credit, and it's going to be our credibility. So you're going to hear about it real soon. We're going to get our own credit union. We're going to have our own bank to loan money among us. It's going to happen. So if you get in that tight, we can say, hey, we got you covered. This is what you need to do. Go pay that bill off and pay us $25 a month for the next 6 months. So we just got to find ways, because and that would not have violated anything. We move with integrity. We gave you a fair interest rate, because the proverb says God hates unfair waste and balance. We didn't charge you no additional interest. We didn't make any extra money off of you. We just helped you bear that load for that season. Our credibility goes up. Your bill goes down. We all make it. But we got to find ways, because the world has ways that they got from Scripture. They got it from Scripture. But we've been so uneducated about it that we don't know how to capitalize. But if the same tax law, I went to a meeting last night about the Urban Renewal Initiative, URI. Went to a Tuesday night, then. You heard about it? Urban Renewal Initiative. You know that President Trump, through the tax laws, in the first year of his administration, released billions of dollars for us to use in our community to make our communities better. He didn't release it to us. He released it to the business owners. And he says, big business, if you come down here and invest in these low-income areas, I'm going to give you 10 years that you're going to be able to write your taxes off. But you got to come down here and invest in these opportunity zones. So if you get in the opportunity zones, which are places where mostly blacks and Hispanics live, so we going to do ministry. In the areas where blacks and Hispanics live, we qualify for businesses that will give us money when they get a 10-year tax break. So they don't pay taxes for 10 years, but we get to build up our homes, build up our schools. So I just went to that thing Tuesday night in the Alabama State. So it's big, but it all came from Trump. But see, we don't hear that part because what he did in that tax law, and setting it up, watch this. It's the, now watch this. This is the downside that I'm checking out now. The 1% up here, they still gonna increase in income. They gonna keep getting richer, but at least we can come out of a hole. At least we can come out of a hole.
Because more than likely, the 1% actually own the property, and they got the real estate.
They own the land.
Right.
They got the resources. I know I talked too long.
No, that's okay. That's okay. And another thing too, and it talks about seven streams of income. Biblical too, right? So you say, I can't do that, right? And ain't for me. That's a resource, right? If God put place something in your way and you reject it, don't complain about being behind on something when you get ahead. It could be just for a season now. It don't have, like what you're doing, like with your LLC, that might not be permanent. That might get you to a place where he got something bigger for you. But we just got to get started in that life. The problem is we won't even get started.